Hi, Doris. This is Salo, and this is your Galactic Starseed Activation Light Language Reading. These are the symbols I see around you. Light language speaks to the soul without words. How cool is that? It bypasses the left side of our brain, which is logic and mathematics, to the right side of the brain, which is creative. It's feelings, it's emotions, it's self-expression without words. So what you're looking at in this moment of time with these symbols is a download of information, packets of information that goes to the right side of your brain. And the package opens up when it is needed for clarity and information. This is like a blueprint of your soul journey that I see around you. So one interpretation is only one of maybe a million interpretations. So right here is your guides and angels coming in, helping and sending energy from the stars, the people and star systems of where you came from. I'm kind of getting, you probably had some experiences on Mars in this galaxy, but also Lyra and some other planets. You come from a long line of warriors. Warriors that fought for land, fought for their right, fought for justice, and to know that they were making changes in the world. But now you are a spiritual warrior, changing over to working with groups and individuals to help uplift those that are less fortunate, to help them become a spiritual warrior without violence in this lifetime is one of your spiritual purposes. So they're sending this down. This first symbol here, my guide said, comes from Japan, a samurai warrior you were. And you were able to protect land and the royalty, and you were very well rewarded. You were very able to lead many men. You were able to be alone with yourself for long periods of time and not need others. And you were very well rewarded for your skills of, you know, movement and being ready at a moment's notice with your skills. So in this lifetime, my guy, so you have this attitude of somebody has a problem. He's like, well, let's problem solve it. Let's not cry. Crying, there's no crying in baseball. So it's about, let's find solutions. Let's be emotionally centered. Let's find where the answers are. And let's bring out, you have this wonderful gift of bringing out people's self-empowerment through the clarity of your example. When you nurture, when you listen to others, when you boost their self-esteem and help them learn to be self-empowered, you are doing your spiritual purpose. You've also been, with this activation too, been on stage, you've been a singer, you've been an entertainer, you've been a VIP, you were applauded by great audiences in the past, and now you're here to applaud others in groups and help uplift them. You know, with your birthday being born on November 6, 1959, 6 is the number of divine love, the mother figure, the wise woman, the sage. And so you provide wonderful information to others in this lifetime and activate their own soul purpose. And so the more that you can nurture others and applaud them, instead of being the star, but working with groups and being the peacekeeper and seeing both sides and making it a win situation, you are doing your spiritual purpose. Now, in your past lifetimes, you used to being alone. So this is a lifetime of partnership, family, community, animals, children. The wise sage in the family is part of your spiritual purpose in this lifetime. These are little stargates that you go through in this lifetime with your spiritual learning and self-expression and moving that out into different, you know, bringing heaven here on earth, creating stargates with your activation of helping others in groups, my guides are saying. These are little signals and vibrations that go out in the community. Here is the samurai warrior. I also feel that you were also in Tibet. I also get Nordic activities, and also in Greece and Rome and all sorts of things like that. It's like this sense of liberation of having the sword leaping forward, and then my guides are saying you're coalescing the sense of partnership up here with this symbol, and then coming together with partners in community. You finally get to reach those goals of family and community and animals and children. You get past that, and from that, through the sum of your own totality of all your past lifetimes of knowing the independence, and then transferring that sense of independence through the clarity of your example to others, you help strengthen others. You help show them that they can have courage. You can help show them that they can do it, and boost them up from their bootstraps and saying, you can do it. This is the self-expression through the emotions of this river here coming through, these little waves of emotions. It's good to self-express yourself in relationships. My guides are saying, be careful with your temper. Sometimes, maybe more so, not now, but when you're younger, you had a very strong temper and wanted answers right away. And now it's about chilling out, being the peacekeeper in this lifetime, because sometimes your strength can sometimes shake others to the core. So be careful with your words, be careful with your anger, and you know what? You got your life purpose going here in the universe and get to utilize it really, really cool. These are other stargates that get activated. These are all symbols. So when you watch these, when they're hung in your home and you go past them each time, or even if you touch the print, you'll receive the vibration and the information that you need to have for this spiritual journey in this lifetime. And so from here, being the individual warrior going into partnership and peacekeeping, that is part of your spiritual purpose and energy that came out into this lifetime. And so know, when you boost others up and help them encourage what their gifts are and help be peacekeeper and using the wise wisdom that you have, oh my goodness, you're going to feel, you'll know what to say, you're going to feel appreciated, you're going to be part of a community, and when you're part of a community, you feel like you belong, where in your past lifetimes, you felt lonely, you felt distanced, you didn't feel like you connected or didn't know how to say the right thing, and now all that comes together in this lifetime, especially with 2020, we are learning these lessons, not just you, but all of us. You're also in a personal year of a 3 in numerology, which means you're learning communication, connecting, networking with others, experiencing the joy of living the best you can, having barbecues with your small intimate family, spending time with family and animals. It's like everyday living. Next year, you may learn something new, go back to school, or even teach. And sometimes people can also move in a 4-year. So I just wanted to let you know. But you also are a 5 in the universal life path number in numerology, which means you're also here to experience freedom, joy, self-expression. Excuse me, my dog's barking a little bit. Self-expression and creativity is so important in this lifetime. So I hope you like these symbols and the light reading. I so appreciate it. If you ever want an hour reading, just contact me. I also have a little link on my Etsy store for a spiritual 1-hour reading for $99. If you're interested in that, it is recorded. It's on the telephone. It's great. We have lots of fun, and I can go in much more detail. So enjoy.